Cardiff are the Championship's form side. While Wolves have set the pace in the league, Aston Villa are revitalised under Steve Bruce, and Fulham are playing some of the best football, Neil Warnock's side have quietly got on with the job of winning. In fact, in the league, Cardiff are unbeaten since January the 1st, a run of 9 wins and 2 draws. They have only lost once in any competition in 2018 to Manchester City in the FA Cup. Cardiff have used a variety of formations this season, including deploying 3 at the back, but have favoured a 4-3-3 or a 4-2-3-1 in their recent run. Kenneth Zuhore leads the line, flanked by Junior Hoylett and Nathaniel Mendes-Lang, in front of a midfield three that generally features Joe Rawls and Loic Demore, who also plays in the hole in the 4-2-3-1, and Liverpool loanee Marco Gruic, who has also impressed in recent fixtures. Cardiff defend aggressively, helped by the physically imposing nature of their back line, Joe Bennett aside. Bruno Manga is a centre-back playing mostly on the right, while Sol Bamba is a significant aerial presence both defensively and offensively, and arguably the best centre-back in the league this season. Bamba especially steps out of the defensive line to close down players, with Bennett covering over from left-back. Indeed, Cardiff's positional fluidity in defence, especially against teams who play it quick and short, can look like disorganisation. In fact, the stepping out and covering across is designed to close down threats and win the ball back irrespective of whether that pulls someone out of their standard position. This defensive movement is aided by the covering of the wide attacking players, especially Junior Hoylett on the left, who works extremely hard to drop back into the wide space to cover Bennett's movement inside. Bennett does not just tuck in to cover for Bamba pushing forwards, he also pushes up into the midfield area if cover there is needed. The Cardiff backline can also shuttle across if this happens, effectively stopping up the centre with 3 centre-backs, and Hoylett and Mendes-Lang covering like wing-backs. In the midfield, Cardiff close down the opposition and tend to follow their men. If Amore is playing in the double pivot rather than the hole, he will still follow the man he is closing, and another Cardiff player covers the space he's vacated. Ahead of this, Kenneth Zuhore rumbles around, pressing the players in possession. Cardiff tend to press more at home than they do away, as might be expected. Warnock's teams have conceded fewer goals than any other side in the Championship. Their combination of movement, aggression and effort is paying dividends. Cardiff's intention is to win the ball back quickly by pushing forwards and then transition straight into an attack by getting the ball into the opposition half. It's a form of vertical football, but once the ball is transitioned quickly and directly, Cardiff are happy to play attractive football. It's not just punted long balls and set pieces, though Cardiff certainly do pose a threat from a dead ball with their height and power. Winning the ball wide means a quick transition to the wide attacking players, who push forwards and look to deliver a quick cross to Zuhore or drive to the byline and cut back for a midfielder coming from deep. Cardiff will use Zuhore as an out ball centrally, and he's good at flicking it onto the wide players cutting inside or back to an advancing midfielder. The central midfielders, Demore especially, are also expected to get up in support and provide late options around the edge of the box. Cardiff get lots of shots off, the second highest number per game in the league, and while Zuhore has scored 7 so far, winger Hoylett and midfielder Patterson are Cardiff's joint top scorers with 8 each. Midfielder Joe Rawls also has 7. Zuhore is the focus of the attack, but his function is as much to disrupt the opposition marking and bring other players into the attack as it is to score himself. Cardiff could unfairly be categorised as a long-passing team, relying on physicality and pace and the exploitation of set pieces. While all of these are strengths, Warnock's side have no little skill and an intelligent defensive system that are both also key to their success. They may not be as silky as Wolves or Fulham, but Cardiff are a very good team who deserve the success that will certainly be theirs this season. For more information about Cardiff, or to keep up to date with the Championship generally, you should download the One Football app. The app offers you access to all the latest news, lots of interesting stats, and various visualised versions of the league tables. There's a link in the description if you want to download it. Thanks for watching.